So with just a couple of months before Witch Queen, it's time to start prepping for the next season. And as we get into the next season, obviously, we'll have new perks, new mods, but one of the most important things that you'll need is good armor. There are many good sources of armor currently within the game. In this video, I'm going to briefly go over what is probably the quickest and easiest way to get 4 guaranteed pieces of high stat armor with minutes of gameplay in a week. Again, for many of you guys who are like me who are part-time guardians, this is a key way to be able to get that key armor that you're going to need to make the best builds going into the Witch Queen. So to do this, we're basically going to use activities within Season of Splicer. That's going to require that you do own Season of Splicer, which also means that you have to own Beyond Light. So you have to have both of those. You need to go through and finish the core activities and the core quest so you have access to the corrupted expunge missions. That's how we're going to do this. So first off, if you're not aware, within the corrupted expunge Tartarus, there's a very, very easy way to get through the encounter with, first off, not having to face a champion, but second off, being able to skip past almost all the ads and go straight to the boss. I'm showing that right here in this clip. There's a key jump you need to make. Once you make this jump, it's pretty easy then to go through the boss. And again, you don't have to deal with any of the ads. That allows you to complete these activities, the specific expunge mission, within minutes. Typically, most of my runs are anywhere from 4 to 6 minutes. So again, it's very easy to grind through really quickly. The other thing you're going to need for this is you're going to need corrupted key codes. If you still have the quest from Season of the Splicer, you should have many of those just sitting in your inventory. If you don't, the easiest way to get them is just go into any activity that has a lot of ads and kill ads. Typically, if you need to do that, you can go to the Thrallway or on the moon. You can do that through going through the Altars of Sorrow public event. That's an easy way to get it. So the other thing you're going to need before you start this is whatever stat you want to be highest. Let's say it's recovery, intellect, whatever it is. You're going to want to use your ghost shell and put the mods on that allow you to have boosted affinity towards getting high stat rolls, because that does come into play with these activities. Your next step is then to go on each of your characters, complete that expunge, the corrupted expunge Tartarus. Then at the end, you'll turn in your key, and that's when you'll get your higher tier armor. Again, I did this on my characters. I was getting like almost 26, 25 on stat rolls very easily. Once you complete those 3 activities, then you'll have enough points. As long as you have tier 3 unlocks on armor for Season of the Splicer, you'll be able to go get another engram. And those are actually really cool because those engrams allow you to specify, hey, I want this specific stat or this specific stat. And that'll give you your 4th piece of high tier armor. Again, there's lots of ways where you can go in and get a high tier armor in Destiny. This is the best way to get it solo and to get it within minutes, which again, for those of you who are trying to fit this into your part-time, this will be a key way to get easy armor for the next season. That's the video, guys. If you like it, feel free to like the video, subscribe to my channel, jump in my Discord, and I'll see you Guardians in the Tower.